Well, thank you for spending a couple more minutes with us today. I assure you this is not a repeat of the presentation that I had the pleasure of sharing with most of you on Tuesday. So it's my understanding that this is a recorded presentation, and so you will have access to all of the PowerPoints after this, even if I skip over a few that you might want to go back and look at. My purpose today is to just give you some practical tips on how to deal with activities that we call academic dishonesty. And so I'm going to give you some practical tips that apply to basically what I call my six-step process of getting ready, handling it, and continuous improvement. Basically, your first job after today is to go back and review both the online tutorial that you are required to take. If you haven't taken it, I wish that you would. One of those is on academic integrity. There's the sexual harassment and the diversity online tutorial. In addition, if not already, in the very near future, the presentation from Tuesday will be put online, and I would ask to go back and review the fundamentals of what is the culture of academic integrity. And if you weren't in attendance Tuesday, I really beg you to go back because it puts everything into the picture. But basically, to tie everything that you've heard in the last couple hours together, everything that you've heard about today has been built on the core values and leads to the ability to achieve our mission and vision. And so I'm hoping that as a result of the ADA lecture, diversity, civility, everything, that you now see the big picture of really the importance of what we need to do and pay attention to provide a fabulous teaching and learning environment for all of our students, including yourselves as a student. So step two, the other thing I'm going to challenge you to do today is to sit back and do some reflection. Take a little quiet time and go off and think about, who am I now today? I'm a teaching assistant. I'm a graduate student. What is your role and responsibility as that teaching assistant? It's a big leap to leave your undergraduate program, come here, and be thrown into a classroom for the first time. But what's going to be so exciting and challenging to you is to feel how you're going to grow into a leadership. So you were already inspired by a previous speaker to say, yes, you are a leader, you have competence, that's why you're here today. So think about how you might just be courageous and stick to your guns and be that leader in the classroom and serve as an example of what a courageous leader can be. This is going to be very, very difficult because many of your students are about the same age as you and they have a lot of the same lived experiences. Simply put, as stated in other presentations, we have a zero tolerance policy for academic dishonesty. Cheating, plagiarism, absolute, not allowed. Intentional, unintentional is viewed as equally a problem, and the consequences are the same. You have a shared responsibility as a TA, along with your students, faculty, staff, to uphold the values of what we are talking about with respect to academic integrity, and you now have no choice but to take action against wrongdoing. Remember that if we don't work together to prevent things and to take actions against it, the value of all of our degrees for all of our programs is diminished. The faculty and TA are expected to use approved strategies to evaluate student work for cheating and plagiarism. I'll have a couple for those for you. But most importantly, all of the concepts that have been talked about by Kevin West and others that you've heard today, we must address students in a fair and equal manner. They are afforded due process. So it's not about you're going into your classroom and feeling like you're going to trap somebody and go and every day you go into the classroom or the lab, you're going to catch somebody do something. No, it's about what we can do to create a culture of inclusion such that some of the temptations are gone away. The preparation of step three is to prepare before the class. Some of you have already made some comments about the syllabi that you're preparing. Maybe you won't be preparing your own syllabus by yourself, but the faculty of record, meaning the person really that's going to sign off on the class, is preparing that syllabus and giving it to you. But whoever is in charge of the syllabus, whatever faculty or department chair that you're assigned to, please meet with that person before your class begins. Some of you may be in the classroom Monday morning at 8 o'clock. So please contact the faculty member that is your direct mentor and talk with them about all of the policies in the syllabus. And after today, do you think something's missing that should be included? As well as talk about what does that faculty do when acts of academic dishonesty are discovered so that you have a plan in place. And the other thing I'm going to challenge you to do is the last bullet item, and that is to create some kind of a folder, whether it be on your laptop, an iPad, whatever kind of electronic device you use, or paper and pencil that's in an old-fashioned three-ring binder. It doesn't matter. I'm going to show you that there are several policies and procedures that I'm going to ask that you take copies of either electronically or on paper and have them ready for you, and they begin with any of the handbooks that are concerning your program. The Undergraduate Student Handbook, which is available online, College of Graduate Studies handbook, you really will be useful to you, even though most of you are going to be teaching undergraduate, the individual college handbooks, and then any academic policies specific to the program that you're teaching in. And as well as a bunch of other policies, and these are the web links. I'm not going to pull these up. I just wanted to collect them in one place for you such that after today's presentation, you'll take some time and download the copies and read them. They're boring as heck. I realize that. So maybe you might want to do that close before bedtime and then fall asleep, but to at least collect it together and refer to it periodically. But also, there is a bunch of policies and procedures that I didn't really mention on Tuesday's presentation, and they are specific to the undergraduate population, and they have plenty of fancy numbers, titles, and web links as well, and additional policies regarding research misconduct. So there's a lot of homework for you to do very quickly to get your little notebook together of the policies and procedures that will let you help guide you to give due process and treat everybody fair. Everyone must have equal opportunity. But probably more exciting and dynamic is step number 4. Take action to prevent your students from committing acts of academic dishonesty in whatever environment you're teaching, whether it's face-to-face, online, a laboratory, whatever. And that is to just go back to that behavior. Some of the information you received today describing your learner, the behavior of the learner, acts of uncivil behavior. There's reasons why students make the wrong decisions. And a lot of it goes back to their stress in their lives. Maybe they didn't know about things before. And so you, as the leader educator, needs to make the student aware of what is cheating and plagiarism so that they know what it is and know not to do it. The other thing that you can do is set an example. So in your classroom, every action that you do, every action you do outside the classroom, thinking back to what Mr. West was talking about, you need to be handling yourself in the most professional manner as possible. You may, so that you will be respected, even though your age difference might not be as broad as, say, maybe I'm much older than my students. There are a lot of resources that you can put, make available to your students by way of the website for your class, or just writing them on the syllabus or posting them in class. We have tutoring, we have writing centers, facilities in the libraries, all of this stuff that is beyond what you have time to do. Steer your students in that direction so that they can get all of the assistance possible for them to make the best decisions, help reduce the stress of learning, and fill in what you can't do in your short time with them in the classroom setting. We have a lot of tricks of the trade, as I call it, or electronic things. And I know that for you, some of you are coming brand new to the University of Toledo, and there's a couple phrases up here that probably look totally out of context. Respondus lockdown browser, safe assignment in Blackboard. I don't expect you today to know what those are. The reason that this program is going to be put online for you is to have you go back to it, look at those, and then ask your faculty or a library person or call me, and I'd be happy to meet with you and tell you how to use some of the electronic as well as in-person facilities that we have at the University of Toledo that will allow you to create a very secure environment that is going to minimize some of the opportunities for cheating and plagiarism. But at the bottom, precise assignment instructions, and that goes back to your syllabus, being very clear what it is you want your students to do. There's other types of things, plagiarism tutorials with signed certificates. Again, I'd be happy to share this information with you and or your faculty of record. Most of your faculty know about some of these, so they would be the first person. If they don't know, please call me. The fifth thing that you need to do, and this is the one we hope never happens, and that is just in case somebody cheats or plagiarizes under your watch in your classroom, the most immediate thing you need to do is contact the faculty of record, and then be sure that you've got your policies and procedures straight. That's why I said get your little notebook in order. And then document. What we mean by that is sit down with a paper and a pencil or on your computer and create a record for your memory of the time, date, the person, the evidence, such that you have it immediately at the most instant time when your memory is the freshest, such that as the investigation process goes forward, you can give the best accurate information that will be protecting you from false accusation, as well as best assisting the student in coming to the best possible outcome for that student. And then finally, step six. I hope that this is not the only semester that you'll be having the pleasure of teaching our students at the University of Toledo. And so even though today seems a little bit maybe overwhelming and like, oh my gosh, this stuff is really serious being a TA. I thought it was going to be all kinds of fun. I promise you it will be fun to teach our students and that you will continually improve in your own professional skill set. So even though today may seem overwhelming, you will continue to improve, and how you're going to improve is in two big ways. Use the faculty that are teaching the courses that you take as some role models. See how they teach, see how they take strategies to prevent cheating and plagiarism, and then do whatever you possibly can to strengthen your own academic writing and speaking skills, and that will feed into a better teacher. And know that there's resources for you to go get continuous improvement strategies to assist in your learning, such as the Writing Center, professional development programs that the College of Graduate Studies will post on its website, as well as lots of things in the library. But most importantly, leave this session today a courageous person. Leave this room a leader. You are a leader right now. Enjoy your journey, and best of luck. Thank you for your attention.